You know, this AI thing is really changing how educators are seeing their role. You mentioned about, I don't have to spell anymore, or do I have to write anymore? And so what is the role of AI in education, do you think?
I mean, I feel like there are a lot of things that are very traditional in the sense of, oh, when I was this age, we needed to know this, we needed to know how to spell. And that was very important, and that was something that was seen as like very elite. But then like as we get spell checking in, education, you can then focus on other things and prioritize other things. It's kind of like how the amount of times people ask me, like we go out to dinner and they're like, oh, how much is the tip? And I'm like, I don't know. They're like, aren't you a software engineer? Shouldn't you know how to do math? I'm like, no. I'm an engineer. We invented calculators, so we didn't have to do this. And then at least what I liked about using calculators is that then I could focus more on like setting up the problem, more like the high level things, and then having that all taken down and not spend as much time being like, oh, I need to do all these other things. And so it's just interesting, like, I feel like sometimes it's some of the fear of AI is like, oh, these basic like fundamental skills are like the first building blocks that you're going on to the next thing. It's kind of getting taken over, so you can step up sooner. So what else? So I feel like as AI gets more prevalent, we might be focusing more on like higher level education and like thought as opposed to some of the ground level ones.
Wow.
And what are you thinking over there? I'm not sure, but definitely add in the comments when you can, because this is a fundamental question. For you, John, how does it make you think of how people get educated today?
Yeah, I'm thinking of you learning math.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to teach my daughter calculus.
Mm-hmm.
And the one thing I love about ChatGPT and those systems is that you can ask it the dumbest questions. So if you don't understand how a mathematical equation is solved, you can just say, well, explain this to me. And then if you don't understand that explanation, you can say, explain that to me. And you can go as deep as you like. You can go down to the fundamentals, and it never gets bored or angry or irritated with you. I think it's a perfect teaching tool because you can just ask it anything at any level whenever you want. And I don't think that means you don't need to understand it, and therefore you've got brain capacity spare to learn about art and ethics and music more. I think it's just having the best teachers available all the time. The best teachers in
the
human
access.
History.
As I mean, also, if you think about, I mean, if you ever talk to a software engineer, they say most of my job is looking up how to do my job. And there's also a skill of being able to know how to ask certain questions. Mm-hmm. And I feel like with like, you know, the like AI and all the other things, it lets you, gives you tools so you can like start asking the questions. Cause like, I mean, so much of coding is like, oh, if someone's already done it, I can just copy and paste it. But you still need someone who'd be like, figure out how to take the pieces and put it together.
Right.
And AI is not gonna take away people putting the pieces together, but AI will make the pieces more accessible.
AI is also really good at telling you what pieces you need.
Yeah.
That if you don't know how to do something and you don't even know where to start, you can completely, without embarrassment, ask, get me started on this.
Oh, the without embarrassment part, that's important.
I think what's wonderful is you're describing, I mean, Eleanor, you keep contextualizing things as the natural evolution.
Mm.
And so that makes me excited. John, you are just as young and spirited as Eleanor. And you're like, oh, I'll do that. It makes me think about how I was in a Uber recently where the driver was asking me how could he become an aviation engineer. That was his career goal. And I told him about how you could use ChatGPT to like talk with while you're driving to learn while he's driving, take all the materials, have this really, really understanding coach guide them through it. And you can see that he got actually optimistic that he could probably have a chance. So your point on access is so key.
Yeah.
So education out there, a little bit choppy, but these are tools that are completely understanding, not empathetic, they're machines, but they can perhaps guide you to a better path. So let's keep moving forward on a better path with AI in corners like this. Thanks.
Thanks.